Today, as I told you, we'll be discussing about the changes in the material master. There are some small changes in the material master, not like the ones we discussed in the business partner, because the customer, vendor and business partner, this is something which is a big change, because the way in which we are creating and all that is something has been completely changed. But if I talk about the material master, it is not much change, because MM01 will work. The transaction will remain same. The first change that you will see is that the length of the material number. So earlier, what was the maximum length? It was only 18 characters. So you can create a material master with material number that is maximum of 18 characters. But now with SAP S4, SAP is providing the option that you can create the material up to 40 characters. The material number can be up to 40 characters. Now, coming to why exactly this requirement came and was it not available earlier in ECC. So this is not a new requirement. The customers, some of the customers in discrete industry, automotive industry, they were already asking for this particular requirement even in ECC also. But what SAP has done is they provided the SAP note. Okay, and if you implement that SAP note, the functionality becomes available. Okay, you can use up to 40 characters. Even in case of the customers who are using the DIMP solution, DIMP solution, in that case, by default, if you activate the DIMP components, it was supporting up to 40 characters. But normally, if I talk about the normal scenario when we are not implementing DIMP, we are not implementing any of the SAP note, it was only supporting up to 18 characters. Now, in SAP S/4HANA, even if you don't activate DIMP, even if you don't activate any SAP node, by default, SAP is allowing you to create the material up to 40 characters. Now, it is your choice whether you want to use this functionality or you don't want to use this functionality. If you want to use this functionality, you need to activate it from one of the configuration. So, for example, currently, because I have not activated that functionality, if I try to create a material with more than 18 characters and click on enter, although this error is in German, but this means that it is still only supporting 18 characters. So what we need to understand now is where is that configuration, from where we can maintain that yes, we want to use the functionality of having more than 18 characters. And then the second question is, if system is supporting up to 40 characters, if we activate that, is it necessary that we need to use 40 characters only? Can we not use the characters in between 18 and 40? So for example, if I want to use only 25 characters, is it possible? Okay, so these two things I'll show you first of all before going to the next things. So that particular configuration is available in SPRO. Within the SPRO IMG, you will be going to the general application functions, which are available in the cross application component. So cross application components, general application functions, and here you have this field length extension. Okay, and here you will get the option of activate the extended fields. Before I go into the execution part, let's go through the documentation, what it exactly it is trying to say. So in this customizing activity, you can activate the usage of following extended fields in external communication interface. It is only providing you one option, that is extended material number. With this activation in relevant external communication interface, I'll talk about this, such as BAPIs and ADOCs, the system uses only the extended version of the field, for example, the material norm. The extended material number can have the maximum length of 40 characters, and there are the following settings. So if the checkbox is not selected, then system will consider the standard settings, which means it will support only 18 characters. So currently it is not selected. The checkbox is not selected. And that is the reason we are only able to create the material with the maximum length of 18 characters. And if you click the checkbox, if you select the checkbox, so what will happen? For the external communication, the system only uses the extended material number field. Now, requirement is, before you activate the extended field, you must ensure that all your communication partners are able to work with extended versions of the field. Communication partners can be the business partners or other SAP ERP systems. For example, this SAP CRM. Standard settings, as long as you have not activated the extended field, the system for compatible reason does not allow field longer than the length. Now let me tell you the complete understanding of what exactly is written here. Some of the things you got the point, while some of the things like what is communication interface, BAPIs and IDOCS, what exactly it is trying to say. So let's take an example. If you are using the SAP S/4HANA system independently. Independently means you don't have any external interfaces. Okay, so in that case, if you activate the material length functionality of 40 characters, what will happen? You will be able to create the materials with more than 40 characters, sorry, more than 18 up to 40 characters. Now let's say you activated this functionality and you have created some materials with 40 characters length. Now, if you are using some interfaces, if you are trying to send this data through IDOCS or BAPIs or any of the SAP or non-SAP systems to some other ERP, or maybe within SAP you are sending the data to CRM, let's say for example. So it is also important that your other application, which is taking the data from the current system, that should also support up to 40 characters. Okay, which is a very rare scenario. So if you are using the 40 characters in your current system without any interfaces, there is no harm. But if you want that the interfaces also should be able to work as they were working earlier, in that case, if you are activating this functionality of 40 characters, you should ensure that your other components also supports that. Otherwise, what will happen? So you created a material with 40 characters and you are sending this through IDOCS to CRM, which is only supporting up to 18 characters. It will throw the error, right? You will not be able to perform this movement from the ECC to the other systems, or SAP S4 to other applications like CRM and SRM. So that is the reason what SAP is trying to say you is, the requirement is, before you activate the extended field, you must ensure that all your other communication partners are able to work with extended version of the field. If they are not, then it is not recommended to activate this functionality. And saying that, it is also impossible. Once you activate this, you cannot come again. You cannot come back to 18 characters, because what will happen is, once you create a material, if a material exists for 40 characters, you cannot go back to the settings and say, no, I don't want to use this functionality now. So it is always important that don't activate this functionality blindly. If you really need this functionality and you think, yes, my external interfaces will remain unimpacted, because maybe some you will be doing something on your external interfaces also, which will start supporting 40 characters. But if not, it is not recommended to activate this thing at all. Okay, same thing it is trying to say here, that although it is possible from the system point of view to activate it, but before activating, please make sure that your external interfaces are unimpacted. So how are you going to activate it? I'll click on this activate extended fields. I'll click on new entries. So currently, as you can see, it is not checked. Checkbox is not selected, which means this functionality is not active as of now. If I want to activate, I need to click on this tick and click on save. But before that, you also need to, if I press enter, what it is saying, an entry already exists with the same key. Let me see what it is. Cancel. Okay, if I try to save, I think this will ask me for confirmation. Just a minute, this is something which is unexpected. An entry already exists with the same key. I entered a key which already exists, the entry cannot be created. See, now once you click on this display SAP note, then only this is becoming active, because it should not happen that you are not clicked on this and you are just going ahead with making this tick. So what it is saying is, it is always recommended to go for this SAP note first, go through this, understand this, what is written in that, and then only take a decision whether you want to activate this or not. Okay, so I'm not going to activate this, because once it is activated, you cannot roll back, right? So you need to be very much sure whether you want to activate. In the OMSL, you were saying how many characters you are going to use. So currently, although it is mentioned as 35, it will not allow, because it is not supported from the activation point of view at all. So it cannot support more than 18 characters. So if I activate that particular functionality from there, and if I come here and say I want to use only 30 characters or only 35 characters, so that is only up to that only it is allowed. It cannot go beyond that. Right, any questions till now?
So how will the mass seed table look like for the material number character length
after I'll come to the table level. Yes, right. The next thing is that only I'm going to talk about what will be the impact on the standard tables, because it is not only the Mara table. There are a lot of tables which are affected whenever you change this, because whatever transactions you do, MAT, DOC, the new table, even the MSEC, and there are a lot of other tables where the material is going to be stored. So what will be the impact on that? And even if you have created some Z objects, like some Z tables or maybe some Z reports in which you want the material number should be available. So what you need to do and how exactly that will be taken care of, that is something which we'll discuss. But anything till now, whatever we discussed?
Gaurav, this is Vijay. Suppose we activate for 40 characters and we haven't created any materials, then can we deactivate that, or without even creating material, we can't deactivate?
No, if you don't create any material, then you can definitely deactivate, because it will create the inconsistency only when the material exists with the more number than you are specifying here.
Okay, thank you.
Yes. But it is always risky, so it is always better to make sure that you are not going to come back once you activate this. Yes, Arijit.
Actually, so what I gather from what you had said is, first of all, if we want to extend the material length, first we activate the functionality from SPRO, and then suppose if we want 30 character length for material number, we have to enter 30 over in this field, and then both will be activated. Is that what you said?
Yes. Yes, you're right. See, this is not a new screen. The current screen that we are seeing, this OMSL, this is the old functionality. What exactly it does is, although in ECC we have the maximum cap of 18 characters, right? But still, if you want to have the materials of lesser than 18 characters, we can come here and we can specify that for our purpose, we are only going to use 10 characters. Similarly, now also, from the functionality point of view, when you activate the extended number functionality, so system supports up to 40 characters. But it doesn't mean that always you need to create the 40 characters material. So you can specify that although 40 are available, but we want to use the materials only up to 30 characters.
Okay, thank you.
Hey, Gaurav, what is this lexicographical?
Lexicographical, I need to check because this is something which was even available in ECC also, the leading zeros and lexicographical. It is just a minute, this is the example. Or maybe somebody who has worked on this can comment on this. I think this is the... No,
this is Ravi, the way it is stored is what it is actually.
Yeah.
So normally it is...
If you look at the Excel sheet, when you store let's say 008, it can become 8, right? Sometimes, unless you format the cells and make it as a character. Generally it assumes that okay, 008 is 8. So that is what it is mentioning, or that is what it is used for. So basically this is saving... this whole functionality is about how it is stored, and if you're like, for example, even if you activate the 40 character and mention 25, it's basically optimizing the storage.
Okay, so internally in the database, you mean to say if there are leading zeros, they will not be considered, and it will only consider the numbers which are available.
Correct.
Right. So let's go through these examples. It will make clarify. So what it is saying. The way numerical materials are stored in the database, it is also possible to set this indicator if no numeric material numbers have been used yet in the system, since they would no longer be interpreted. Okay, if this indicator is not set, numerical material numbers are padded with leading zeros and stored right justified. Yes, we know normally when you create any material, so let's say for example, the same example that I think somebody has given now. So let's say for example, if you create a material and you there is a background noise. Yeah, if you have created a material and in your configuration, if you said I'm going to use 18 characters and you are creating the material with 5 characters, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So normally what happens in the background, in the table level, it gets stored as the leading zeros. So there will be 13 leading zeros and finally it will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that is something which is unnecessarily consuming the memory, because the zero storage is also something which definitely will consume the memory. So if you want that it should not be stored in that way, you can tick on this indicator. So what will happen is internally, externally assigned number will be created like this, and this is the normal behavior. But if you tick this, this will be stored as this only, 1, 2, 3 only. Okay, there are some other examples also. Let's try to understand this. Material numbers are stored as follows. If the material number was assigned externally, yes, it will be stored in the same way. If it is 1, 2, 3, it will be only stored in 1, 2, 3. Okay, and that may have been stored too. This makes it possible to distinguish between the any leading zeros that may have been entered are stored too. Okay, so if somebody has written 0, then it will distinguish between the material numbers 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay, yes, so what will happen is if you specifically write 0000123, then that will be considered as a text and it will be stored as it is. So let me give you the example. Let me just remove this. This is related to the last session. Yes, so for example, first talk about the material is, or this indicator is not set. Okay, and you are trying to create a material with 1, 2, 3, and the length that you defined is 8 characters. I'm taking the same example. So internally it will get stored like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 leading zeros and 1, 2, 3. Okay, now if indicator is set and if you create 1, 2, 3, it will be stored as 1, 2, 3 only. There will be no leading zeros. But if you are specifically, when you are creating the material, you are specifically giving 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 1, 2, 3, then the leading zeros will not vanish. They will remain as it is. because these two numbers will be considered as two separate numbers. Okay, so this is what the hexadecimal can give to you. But this is not new. This was available even in ECC also. Even this complete screen, OMSL, this is not a new screen. Only thing is, earlier it was only restricted to 18 characters. Now you can specify up to 40 characters. Okay, any questions? Okay, let me now talk about the table level. Now, see, if we just increase the length of this field, we also need to consider what will be the impact of this, because there are a lot of tables which are using this material number, and in the definition it has been mentioned that this will be up to 18 characters. So now if I am using, let's say, 5 different tables, just an example, there are many tables like that, but I'm giving you the example of 5 tables. Now if I want that, I want to extend the length of this from 18 to 40. So if I do this in 3 tables, by the definition, by the technical definition, if I go and change the field length from 18 to 40, and while the other two tables are still holding up to 18 characters, then it will be the huge inconsistency, and definitely system will throw dumps in that case. Okay, so what SAP has done, they made sure that each and every table, wherever these characters are being used, wherever the material number is used, they made sure that at all that places, it will be replaced from 18 to 40 characters. Okay, so it is already replaced from 18 to 40 characters in all the tables, wherever this material number is used. But the problem is, if you have some custom tables which are holding the material number, again, there are two options. Within the custom tables, there are two options. So when a programmer, a mapper creates any particular table or any particular query, normally he provides the length. There are two options of providing the length. One is hard coding. So if you know that, okay, I know material number is only 18 characters. So you can write, okay, I'm going to use this field and the maximum length is going to be 18 characters. And the second option is, even though I know that it is 18 characters, but I don't want to provide any hard coding there. I will provide the reference. I will always say, for checking out what will be the length of the material number, go to table Mara, for example, and find out what is the length and consider that length. So if you have written the code in the second way, if you followed the second approach in terms of identifying the length of a particular field, in that case, system will not throw any error. You can go further and it will be supported. On the other hand, if your code is written in such a way that you have hard coded that it will be used only 18 characters, then definitely there is a problem. And the question here is, how will you identify? How will you come to know how many tables, how many reports, how many forms are going to be affected because of this change? So for that, SAP has provided one tool, which we are anyways going to discuss in detail, which is called as a custom code analyzer tool. What it will do for you, it will check all those places where it has been hard-coded and due to which it will not be supported in the normal way. And what you need to do to rectify that, you need to go to that particular code and you need to adjust. Either you can again hard code, which is not recommended at all, from 18 to 40, or you can provide the reference of one of the table, one of the standard table, mostly it is Mara. Okay, so in this way, from the standard point of view, you don't need to worry. SAP has already taken care wherever material number is used, it is automatically considered as 40 characters. Okay, even if you don't activate this functionality, then also it is considered as 40 characters, right? Because even it is not dynamic. It doesn't mean that if I activate the functionality from the last screen that we have seen, then only the material number will be supported as 40 at table level. At table level, it is always 40, right? Another important thing, if, as I told you, if you found that some of the tables, the Z tables, which are created without any reference to the main tables, they are hard-coded there, you need to make sure that these changes are done before you perform the conversion. Okay, what will happen otherwise, if you perform the conversion without adjusting that codes, you will definitely get the different kind of errors there and it will be completely incompatible. So that is the reason when you are using the custom code analyzer tool, if you find out that some of the tables are not compatible because the length is hard-coded there, you need to change it in ECC itself before migrating to SAP S4. Anyway, that we'll be talking about during the conversion. And last important point, as I told you, the interfaces. So SAP has already made sure the standard tables, whatever the standard scenarios are there, the field length is automatically adjusted. But SAP has not made sure that if you are using some interfaces like CRM, SRM, or some other components, or maybe SAP system, which is two SAP ECC systems are integrated, interfaced with each other, they are communicating with each other. So it should not happen that in one of the system you specified 40 characters and in another system it is only 18 characters. Again, that is a big gap. And that again, you need to try to find out in the initial phase itself before conversion. Before conversion, you find out how many interfaces are there, whether they'll be supporting this new thing or there are some changes required in the other systems also before you activate this functionality. All right, so these are the things that you need to take care from the technical point of view. Any questions?
Yeah, Gauru, this is Vijay again. This change of the field length of the middle master is at the client level or at company core level or something? Or why I'm asking is if there is an STO, there are two company codes, one company code send a purchase order, another company code get a sales order through STO in case of a POSO scenario, in which case, if you activate once at the client level, that is good enough, right?
Yes, yes, yes. It is at the client level. See,
okay. We
are not, even in the screen, you will not see any plant or any company code or any purchasing of. It is always at the client level.
Okay. Thank you.
That is the reason you just need to worry about the interfaces. Within the standard system, it is the client level. So once you activate it, it will be activated for all the different tables.
Okay.
Okay. So, yes, Sharmila.
You said that it is respect activating the functionality, the table will store the 40. For the material.
Sharmila, there is a lot of background noise. Your voice is not clear.
Am I audible now?
Yes, it is better now.
Okay. The thing is, irrespective of activating the functionality, the table will store 40 characters for the material number. So when say there are interfaces, the custom interfaces which will involve the material number, so all that would need to be changed, right? Because by default it will show 40 characters.
No. See, if although system supports 40 characters at the table level, but whatever settings you make, if you don't activate that functionality, only 18 characters will be stored. The remaining 40 characters, for example, if I go for MM01, okay, when I'm creating the material master, although I am allowed to enter 40 characters here, but till the time I don't activate that functionality, it is always going to store up to 18 characters only. So that is only from the technical point of view that the system supports up to 40 characters. But if you don't activate that functionality, you don't need to worry about what are the numbers system is supporting.
So internally you will say that it will store only 18 character, not even the leading zeros, which like the 40 characters, say 1, 2, 3. It will only store 15 zeros.
Yes. Leading characters are only stored if I'll show you here the last configuration that we have done. So here, if you specify, let's say for example, 18 characters, in that case, even if you create the material with 4 characters, then the leading zeros will come. Okay, but if you are specifying here 18 characters, then there is no question of the remaining 22 characters. They will not be holding the leading zeros at all.